Hello and welcome to the ORM Mastery course. This tutorial is part of a bigger course which you can access via the YouTube edition playlist link, which you'll find in the video description. If you really like this tutorial and want to learn more, then please check out our Django ORM Mastery course on Udemy. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. So having now, in the previous tutorial, introduced a background, an introduction to custom fields, let's go ahead now and build our first custom field. And here we're going to create a field, or we're going to subclass from an existing Django field type. So just a quick recap before we start. Here we're going to subclass from a character field. So a character field being an existing Django field type. And let's remember that the character field inherits everything from field. So essentially, when we build a new custom field, we have access to all the attributes and features, behaviors from character field and field. I will give you a quick rundown of what it is we're going to be covering in each section of these tutorials in this section to help you and guide you through this section, determine what it is you want to watch. So in this particular tutorial, we're going to create a new custom field, subclassing from an existing field, and then we're going to discuss the initialization method of our field and take a look at some of the different features that it offers and implement that feature within our new custom field. This is the project that we're working with now. You can apply this to your own application by all means, or you can go ahead and download this code in the video resources. This is a really simple project setup. We have the core project here with the settings, and then we have this e-commerce app here. Inside of here, we have a very simple model setup to begin with, product and category. There is no link between them at all. And you can see that both have one field, and that's the name field. I have activated a virtual environment here, and I'm ready to get going. I haven't migrated yet. We don't need to do that just yet. So let's go ahead and now build a new field from an existing Django field. And that's going to be a character field. So we're just going to go ahead and subclass character field. Right. So first of all, within our app, typically within our app, we create a new file here. And we can call this, for example, fields.py. So any additional fields we might generate that we want to utilize within this app is going to be held within the app. If we were going to create a field which you might want to use on multiple apps, we might move the field file over to core, for example, and then that can then be accessed throughout our own application, or else we might want to build a new folder within the root directory of our project, and we might name that utilities, for example. Inside of that, we might have a field file inside of that. Now, in addition to that, we can also add a custom field directly within our model here if we wanted to. I think that pretty much covers most of the options you have available. Again, there's no right or wrong way here. Depending on how you want to structure your application, it will depend on where you place the custom fields. So let's go ahead and in our field file, let's go ahead and create a new custom fields. So we are going to be subclassing from character field. So we are going to need from Django DB, we are going to need to import models so we can access that. And let's create a new class. And we're going to call this product ID field. So generally, the naming of our new field is something descriptive that helps us recognize the field, and then the word field at the end to recognize that it is a field that we're building. And then that's going to extend. Now, because we're going to use all the features from the character field, let's bring in models.character field. There we go. So we're going to subclass from character field, thus being able to now access all of the features and functionalities of a character field, and then extending to obviously the field class as well. So one of the first attributes, or one of the first items that we want to include, is a description of some sort. So description equals, and then a description of this field, a unique product identifier. So what we're actually building doesn't matter at this point, to be honest with you. But what we're building here is a field where we can add an ID that's going to recognize a particular product. So it might be that our product has an identifier which has letters and numbers. So because it has letters and numbers, I've selected to extend from a character field. For example, if our product ID was just numbers, so an integer, for example, I might pick a field that supports integers. So in this case, my product ID is going to have numbers and letters. So I've selected to extend or subclass the character field. Right, so this is a unique product identifier field. So the idea or the basic setup here is that we're going to need a description. Now at this point, I could just pass. Okay, so which means that there's nothing else that we're going to add here. It's just like a placeholder for code. It does also mean, of course, that we can actually then utilize and implement this class. So let's do exactly that. Let's go back into models. Let's now go ahead and add our new field, so product ID. Now we're going to need to import that in. So from dot fields, let's import product ID field. So that's our new field. So we're going to have a new field called product ID equals, and then the product field. So what we've done so far essentially is we've just subclassed character field. So really all we've created is a new custom field called product ID field, which is just a character field because we haven't made any changes at all and we've given it a different description. So that's pretty much all we've done so far. So if we were to, for example, go ahead and make migrations at this point, you can see that we have an error because by default, if we go into a documentation, which we won't at this point, if we were to create a new character field, remember there is a requirement for us to specify a max length. So because we're inheriting everything from the character field here, we are going to still need to pass that in. And that's why we get an error here. So the max length, sorry, attribute needs to be assigned. So we do need to still actually define our max length. So let's do it right here, for example, for now. And let's see if we can then go ahead and migrate. So you can see now we've created a migration. So let's go back into the migrations and inspect our migration. So we can take a look at our migration here. You can see that we've created a new field called product ID, and it's utilizing the new custom field, product ID field, from e-commerce fields, and it's got a max length of 10. Of course, you can now go ahead and migrate, but that literally is probably the most simplistic custom field that we can build. Simply just subclassing from an existing field and then maybe adding a description. So having put that in place, maybe this diagram makes a little bit more sense than this idea of inheritance. If you weren't familiar with object-oriented programming techniques, makes a little bit more sense now. So what's happening here? We created our custom field. We're inheriting all the information. I say information or the features from character field. Obviously, character field is inheriting from field. So that's all being passed down, of course. And that allows us then to build a new custom field, which has all the characteristics of a built-in character field. Although you're probably well rehearsed with the character field, just a quick recap here that in the documentation, we are told that the character field does have the following extra argument, and that is the max length. Now, what's connected to that max length is an enforcement of a validation. So what's connected to this, or what's connected to the character field, is the max length validator. So behind the scenes, when we define the max length validator, which is a built-in validator in Django, is going to be initiated to check the max length before the data is then saved to the database. So let's now start thinking about actually building some customizations, because all we've done so far is we've just copied an existing class. We haven't actually really made any customizations apart from overriding the description. So here we're now going to talk about the field initialization methods. So the field initialization method can take a number of different parameters. Derived from the field class, we're told in the documentation there's a number of generic parameters that we can pass into our field or define in our field. So let's just spend a little bit of time just exploring some of these different parameters and adding them to our custom field to customize our custom field a little bit further. It is, after all, a custom field, so let's perform some customizations. So we're going to create a new function here. This is going to be a special function in it. So initialization, this is a constructor which gets called when you make an instance of the class. So essentially, whenever we run this code, run this class or build this class or instantiate this class, this code is going to run initially. So let's go ahead and build that. We're going to pass here. Okay. Whenever we create a new field, typically what we do is we pass in some different parameters here. So for example, max length, and then we might specify, for example, blank equals true. We might specify it as a primary key. There's a whole bunch of different options that we have available, which is generic to all the different field types. So this was the list that we were looking at earlier. So here we can pass in any of these different parameters. So max length, primary key, name, blank, unique, null, and so on. So you may already be familiar with some of these different options. So these all derive from the field class. So when we inherit from the field class, these are initially initialized. So we can go ahead and override some of these settings. Now, behind the scenes, these settings are already set for each of our fields, so we can go ahead and override them. And we can do that by essentially overriding the initialization parameters of the field class. So let's take a look at doing that. Right, so first of all then, let's think about what we want to override. Let's just keep this simple, and we're going to specify, so let's go back to our models here. We're going to remove max length from here, and we're going to specify a fixed length for the, oh no, not that one. We're going to specify a fixed length, max length for our product ID field. So let's make all of these arguments, keyword arguments available. So let's pass in self, args, and quarks. Okay, so let's go ahead now and set, for example, the max length. So this applies to any of those parameters that you saw in that list. So we can go ahead and set, for example, the max length. Let's do that manually, and let's set that to, for example, 10. Let's also make this, for example, unique. So that was another option we have available. So this field will be unique. So unique equals true. Okay, so then we need to override. So we're going to use super dot, and then we need init. And then we're going to pass back the args and then the new quags, keyword arguments. So that's going to override and set the max length and the unique parameter for our particular custom field. So again, if you're not familiar to object-oriented programming, to loosely explain super here. So in the, for example, we're inheriting everything from the character field and thus inheriting then from the field class. So what we're using super here for, this is basically just telling Python to essentially override or to access the methods, the initialization method, which another word for a function here in object-oriented programming. We're essentially just accessing the initialization function of, for example, our character field and thus the field class. And then we're just basically performing these updates. So we're just updating, overriding these settings that can be found from these additional classes that we're inheriting from. This is really just a shortcut, if you like, as well. So we don't have to write the code out. Just a little shortcut that allows us to quickly and simply override the settings from other classes that we're inheriting from. Apologies to keep going over this point if it is something that you already understand. So just to try and establish the point here, again, for those who are not familiar with object-oriented programming in general sense, because we've created this structure here, if you like, of inheritance. We're inheriting everything from character field and field. So in field, we have all these parameters that have been defined. And what we're doing in the custom field through super is that we're overriding these features that have been described and defined within the field class. We're overriding them in our custom field to then create our custom field settings. So there we have our custom field. So let's go ahead and delete the initialization, delete the initial migration that we created earlier, just remove that, and then just remove any databases that might have popped up, just get rid of that, and let's just go through the process. We're just going to finish this off now. There isn't any other aspects or attributes that we're going to add to our field, so you might want to skip to the next section if you don't want to see this bit. We're just going to migrate. Let's go ahead and, make migrations. I should just write it down, shouldn't I? Make migrations, just to check to make sure it all works. And then we go ahead and migrate. Okay, so let's go, and here I have the SQLite extension installed. So I have SQLite extension installed here. It looks like it's become very popular over the last couple of months. And then I go into my SQLite Explorer. I right-click on my database. So I open up my database, go down the bottom here. I have now my database open. I can go ahead and have a look at the e-commerce product table. Let's go have a look, show the table. You can see that we don't have any data in it at the moment. Let's go into our side of our table here. You can see the product ID. It is stored in the database as a varchar. So that's how it's stored in the database. So let's go back into the console and just save some data to our new custom field. All right, so let's get into the shell. And let's now go ahead and import that. So from e-commerce.models, let's import product. And then let's go ahead and add some data. So I think it's just two attributes, isn't there? Name, test, and then in addition to that, we have product ID. So let's add a product ID. Product ID equals, and then just create a product ID. So the max length is 10. Now, if we were to enter data in this manner, this would not get enforced here, because we are utilizing, primary reason, because we're using an SQLite database. But let's remember these attributes here that we're setting, they would also be utilized. If we were to open up the, for example, the Django admin area and were to try and enter data, this would be enforced so that we couldn't enter data into our database, which had a character length of more than 10. So here it would, in actual fact, if we're utilizing the terminal, it would not be utilized at this point. But let's just go through this. So we've got the product. Let's add some data. Apologies. We need to make that into a variable. So x equals product. And then let's go for x.save. And there we go. So we have some data. So I just refresh, have a look at my product table again. You can now see that we've saved to our table. So the unique parameter, let's just see, check to make sure that works here. So we've set the unique parameter here. So let's try that again. So I just set up my variable again, x, with the same data. Now the product ID is the same, so hopefully we should receive an error. There we go. So this has been enforced. Uniqueness has been enforced. Unique constraint failed. So that's the first set of resources, something to first think about when creating a new custom field. Think about the field initialization parameters that we can set. Here you've seen that we've set them, or we've enforced them onto our field. So we don't need to specify them when we create our field here. So you can see that when we open up our field, or when we create our field in our code, we don't have to now specify them within our model here, because they are hard-coded into our custom field. And finally, of course, this applies to pretty much all of the different parameters here. So you can go ahead and think about when building a custom field, the parameters that you might want to set. All the links to the resources that we've used today is in the tutorial resources. So you can go ahead and find them there. Needless to say, there are many different options available when creating custom fields. And this, of course, is just the starting point. Generally, most of the examples that we provide in this section is just focusing in on some of the more common aspects of building a custom field.